Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down and to part 3 of this Kranich 2 glider from the Tony Ray range of aero models. And this kit was kindly supplied for build and review by Steve Webb Models. Please remember to like and subscribe to support the channel. And I'm here today on Pendle Hill in Lancashire where we're going to conduct the maiden flight. If you missed parts 1 and 2, the build and fit out of this model, I'll put a link up here for you to enjoy. So let's start by checking the centre of gravity and the trims. And I think we need a bit more down elevator trim here. For those of you that have never experienced it, slope soaring a vintage glider on a nice warm day like this is pure joy. The breeze was very light on this occasion, perhaps 3 or 4 miles per hour, whilst the direction was varying on and off the slope. She responded well to the light lift though, and the handling was very nice. If you remember, there were no control throws given, so I'll pop them on the screen here and in the description below.
Oh, that was quite a walk, and the wind is just a little bit lighter than forecast and the direction's off a bit for this slope. So we're going to stop there and regroup next time. However, I am happy that the centre of gravity is set correctly, the control throws are correct and the trims are fairly close. So it's looking promising for future flights when we come back and try again.
It's worth noting that despite the very lightweight construction, she's actually quite robust, which means it should easily handle the rigours of slope soaring.
So we saw how it performed on the slope, albeit the conditions weren't quite right. So while we have this good weather, we've come to a flat field to try some aerotows.
Here we're connecting up to our trusty Multiplex Funcub XL and we'll see how our homebrew tow release performs. You don't need anything fancy to tow up this glider, and the Funcub is way overkill. Brilliant, the tow release mechanism releases perfectly every time. In 1940, a full-size Kranich, or crane, glider achieved a record height of 37,600 feet. Safely down. Let's connect back up to the tug and have another go. From the second tow, you'll notice the very low sink rate, and this glider should respond to very light lift. It's just there wasn't much about on this day. In conclusion, this kit is well worth the enjoyable build, even though there's a lot of building. The design is charming and unusual and flies well. The laser cutting is of premium quality, and I'm sure that Tony Ray will address the few issues we found during the build for future releases of this kit.
So that was very encouraging. We have a little bit more trimming to do, but she's lovely to fly. Should you wish to build yourself one of these, pop along to Steve Webb Models for a kit and tell them we sent you. Hope you enjoyed that, and thanks for watching.